Why did the gods create him? The Black Monster. He appears in various legends as a demon who rebels against and devours the gods. An evil plague that rejects peace in the world. The god that is the moon that never sets. The moon that never sets glows red every 108 years. It is a sign that a herald will be sent to Earth. The herald is known to us as the Moonchild. The legend says the Moonchild revives the gods on Earth and purifies the world. The Black Monster abhors, hates, and despises it, and kills the Moonchild. This sad karma is endless. This god stays forever in the sky, and the world is in never-ending chaos.
have been waiting for this moment.
I kept you waiting so long. I'm sorry.
Time has come. This is the end of our long journey.
Zeke!
Could you come with me?
Yes! I will never leave you again.
Great Commander, this way.
So, this is her. Put her in custody. Is this really necessary?
It is His Majesty Emperor Dole's command to take that girl into custody.
Who is she?
That is not your concern.
Creator Soa descended from the sky. and his followers created the world. In the end, Soa sowed a seed on the earth. The seed soon grew to be a great tree. The great tree bore 108 fruits, and various life forms arose from the ripened fruits. Thus, 108 forms of life created to fill the world with life. The divine tree completed its role, but the story says it is still protected by the signet of Soa.
In astronomy, a moon that never sets cannot exist.
It cannot exist?
That's right. Stars travel the sky by catching the winds of time. But this moon isn't affected by time. It never moves day or night. That's why it's called the moon that never sets. After counting 108 years, when the moon that never sets glows red, a moon child descends upon the earth to fill the world with holy bliss. A poem of yore telling the fate given by the moon. However, what we really get is the spawning of destruction and fear, that is, the Black Monster.
Black Monster!
Blessing? What does it mean? The mystery has yet to be resolved.
As if they were gods, Winglies ruled over all living creatures and used them as slaves. The enslaved suffered a terrible domination and injustice. Their anger turned to a flame of fury. Then a gust of wind blew throughout the lands, spreading the flame to a blazing fire. The wind was Emperor Diaz. 7 incarnations of dragons served the Emperor. Their bravery inspired people to take up arms. Thus began the Dragon Campaign. It was a harsh war. Both people and Winglies suffered countless injuries and fatalities. After a long period of suffering, it was the humans who acquired the future. The Age of Humans had begun.
There were 7 Dragoon warriors in the legend of the Dragon Campaign. Dragoons, reputed to be the incarnation of dragons. With dragons at their side, the Dragoons fought boldly. However, in the age when the legend was reality, the Winglies dominated all, even the gods. The gods answered to dictator Melbu Frama's prayers and granted him ultimate power. But the power was abused. The earth of Saint Imperial Gloriano was scorched by the gods' fire and became ashen,
The anger and sadness of the people was fuel for the Dragoon's cause. And at last they freed the gods. Without the gods' power, the Winglies perished, and our age, the human age, began. Thereafter, the gods floated in the sky. For 11,000 years, they have been looking over the world as the moon that never sets.